وبعد فالإنسان ليس يشرف إلا بما يحفظه ويعرف، لذاك كان حامل القرآن أشرف الأمة أولي الإحسان، وإنهم في الناس أهل الله.
الله سبحانه وتعالى has blessed us to get to the rulings of نون الساكنة والتنوين, the rules of نون الساكنة والتنوين. However, unfortunately, last lesson, subhanAllah, we did not have the projector, which made it difficult for, I think, maybe the brothers and sisters to take notes, because there was maybe a lot of information. Well, the good news is the information today is more than last time. The bad news is there's no projectors today either. So, yeah. The projector here, yeah?
Yes, and the one that we have is not really working. So next week, instead of the full class, they can print it out or follow on their phones.
Jade, okay, sure. So can what we cover today, I'm going to send it to you. Can you be sending it like today or tomorrow?
I think today or
tonight. Do you have all emails? Do you have everyone's email? So if they don't, just put it down. Jade, inshallah. JazakAllah khair, akhi Naeem. Our brother Naeem, alhamdulillah, has made it easy for you, my brothers and sisters, inshallah, due to his mention that our projector that we have anyway is very bad and you can hardly see anymore when we use it. So what's going to be done, inshallah, from next week onwards, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, is I will be sending the slides, inshallah, once finished, to brother Naeem, and he will be sending them to all of you via email, inshallah. So what happens is when you come to the class, have it opened on your laptop if you want, or on your phone, if possible, and if anyone doesn't have a phone or laptop, or you could print it out, inshallah ta'ala. JazakAllah khair, akhi Naeem. And you could follow me, inshallah ta'ala, in the lesson. What I would advise you to do today, if you want, of course, take notes. That's, inshallah, what we ask everyone to do. But sometimes what some brothers find and sisters helpful is to record audio faqat. Yani the halaqa, even though Akhi Abdul Samad is recording it. And when you get the notes via email tonight, inshallah, or tomorrow, it will make more sense to you, bi-idhnillah azza wa jal. Especially today, actually, there is quite a lot of information that I'll be giving to you, inshallah azza wa jal. And for the brothers and sisters that have not given the emails, write them on a piece of paper, inshallah ta'ala, and give them to the front, inshallah, and Akhi Naeem will take them and take care of them, inshallah. Jayid. Let's start, bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal, a quick revision and recap of what we did in the last lesson, inshallah. So we spoke about ahkam nun al-sakinati wa tanween, and we said that there are four rules under this section, which are what? Al-idhharu, wal-qalbu, wal-idgham, wal-ikhfa. And we spoke about two of them, if I'm not mistaken. And those were the first two, al-idhhar, well, iqlab, or also now known as al-qalb. We said al-idhhar was what? Who wants to define it? Or shall I define it and make it quicker? Yes, Akhi Habib, tafaddal. If loud, so inshallah the sisters can hear. So when the noon sakin or tanween comes and you have after it one of the six throat letters, which are what? Al-hamzatu wal-ha'u wal-aynu wal-ha'u wal-ghaynu wal-kha. Any of those six letters, if they come after a noon sakin or tanween, you must pronounce the noon sakina clearly. This is a revision, brothers and sisters, so we're moving quick, inshallah. My question is, can idhar happen, or does idhar happen within one word only, or it could happen between two separate words?
Two separate words.
So one or both, jazakallahu khairan. It happens in both. You could have it when it's within one word, such as in Surah Al-Fatiha, an'amta, jazakallahu khair. An'amta, noon sakina, after it, ayn, a throat letter. And within or between two separate words, such as hakiman, alima, or aliman, hakima. Jayid? Jayid. That's it about idhar. Very simple, alhamdulillah, and nice and easy. Now, of course, there are some common mistakes we mentioned, So go back, inshallah, to the recording for the common mistakes about or how people fall in, or the common mistakes people fall into in Adhar. Jayd, the next rule we covered last time was Al-Qalb. And I explained why I prefer to call it Al-Qalb rather than Al-Iqlab due to the origin of the word in Arabic linguistically, Wallahu A'lam, is that Al-Qalb, when we asked, it means heart, sah? Lakin originally, it does not mean the heart. It means something that changes. So, Ilmuhim, what's most important, inshallah, is to understand the rule and to apply it correctly, inshallah. And that is what? To change the Noon Sakinati or At-Tanween into what? Impure or hidden meme. Jazakumullah khair. They're going to say meme now. Because a lot of books, or you'll find that they define it and they say to change the Noon Sakinah or At-Tanween into what? A meme. Now, to be more accurate, inshallah, more professional, we should say what? To change it to a hidden, like you find some books in Arabic, مثل المنير في أحكام تجويد, it says what? To change the Noon or Sakinah into a hidden or impure meme. So you have taken something away from the meme. You're saying a meme, but it's not a full original or a pure meme. Jayid? And we said, for example, mim ba'd. Yes, an original meme will be mim ba'd with pressure on the lips. Al qalb, and the same with ikhfa shafawi, is what? To make it impure with no pressure on the lips. So you feel like your lips are going to open. Now we said there is another opinion that some ulama follow, which is to open your lips in a way that you could fit a paper. And we said, now this is an opinion, inshallah, you don't just hit it against the wall. Walakin, the strong opinion, inshallah ta'ala, is to close your lips, but do not pressure it. Jayd, any questions about those two rules that we have covered in the previous lesson? Okay, we'll move on to our next topic today, and that is Al-Idgham. Al-Idgham. We may need to use the board, Allahu A'lam. Lakin, we try and see. It would be very helpful, subhanAllah, or it would have been very helpful for us to have the project. Lakin, inshallah, khayraha fi ghayriha. So, Al-Idgham. Now, I want to mention something about this word. A lot of brothers, they fall into the mistake, and sisters, of course, fall into the mistake. Instead of saying idgham, they say idgham. I've seen it a lot, and I do not know where they got this from. I think because the way it's spelled in transliteration, yeah. When you write it, sometimes some people in certain books they write it and they may say idgham, yeah. And actually, some ulama they very harsh when it comes to writing the Quran in transliteration, and they've gone far and said it's haram. Now, we know this is not a fiqh lesson, ولكن as a professional, you're speaking to yourselves. I mean, you guys are the professionals, inshallah. You should not ever recite the Quran in transliteration. If you do, then say goodbye to Arabic. You're never going to learn it. Jayid, because it's an easy way out. Yeah, and I remember one of the mashayikh once was saying these books should be burnt, the ones with the transliteration. Due to what? Keeping you away from learning the Arabic language, writing it and reading it. And of course, learning and writing is part of our deen. And like Umar ibn Khattab, I think, radiallahu anhu, is the one that said, تَعَلَّمُ الْعَرَبِيَّةَ فَإِنَّهَا تَزِيدُ فِي الْعَقْلِ. Learn the Arabic language because it increases in the brain, in wisdom, and in ذكاء, والله أعلم. So, of course, it's part of our deen. And as a person that wants to learn recitation of the Quran, you must, inshallah, try and use the Arabic. And if you want it in English, translate it. Don't do transliteration. Jayid. Al-Idgham. What does Al-Idgham mean? To merge. To merge one thing into another. Jayid? When you're speaking, of course, in the Arabic language. When we come to the science of Quran, it is to what? To merge the letter before the Noon Sakina. Or Tanween. Why? When I say to merge what? To hide what? We said to what? You go to the main heading. If you remember last lesson, we're referring always to what? The main heading, which is what? To hide or to merge or to change or to pronounce clearly what? The Noon Sakina or what? Tanween. Now, what is the Tanween? Just a reminder. It is a Noon Sakina. So we could just say Noon Sakina. Sah? Tanween is a Noon Sakina that's hidden there. Yes, when we say Aliman, what's the last thing I said? Noon Sakina. Alimun, Noon Sakina. Sah or la? And same thing with Tanween Kasr. So, in the ruling of that we have here, it is to merge the Noon Sakina, or the letter before the Noon Sakina, into the letter after the Noon Sakina. When? If any of the six Idgham letters come after Noon Sakina or Tanween. So again, it is to merge the letter before the Noon Sakina into the letter after the Noon Sakina or Tanween. If they are what? Any of the six letters, or the six following letters, يرملون. We remember them by saying يرملون. Yeah? الياء والراء والميم واللام والواو والنون. Yes? So ياء, راء, ميم, لام, واو, and نون. That's just simple. So for example, if I have a waw after a nun sakin, I say miwal. Now, it does not, it is not applied like this. But how do you merge? هكذا. Of course, there is ghunna given here, but we're going to be speaking about the ghunna in our next step, inshallah. So how do we merge? We skip the nun sakina and we go straight to the next letter. Sometimes applying ghunna and sometimes without applying ghunna. Yes? Jayid. Now, idgham. So what are the six letters of idgham? Yarmaloon. Yeah. Ya, ra, Meem, Lam, Waw, and Noon. Jayid. I repeat them just in case you haven't managed to write them when I said them the first time. So idgham is split into how many types? Two. But this is when it is, these two types, or it's split into two types regarding what? The ghunna. Jayid. Can idgham be split in any other way or in more or less than two? Naam. Which is three types. Al-idgham can be split into two types when we are speaking or referring to what? The ghunna. Two types in regards to ghunna. With and without ghunna. That's two types. Walakin, if we want to go further and more advanced, it is split into three levels, which ghunna will be included in it, as well as something else to do with the attribute of Noon Sakina Tanween. So I'm going to make it easy. The first time, I'm going to do it in two different ways. I'm going to explain to you the two types of idgham, and this is how you will teach younger children. Yes? Yani, when you're in a madrasa and teaching ahkam of tajweed, you're not going to go and explain to the children, you could do it if it's regarding the ghunna this way, and if it's the kid is going to be lost. Yeah? La. You break it down easily, two types, with and without ghunna. Yes? One, you use your nasal passage, you use your nose, and one, you do not. Yes? Jay. So, when we are speaking about idgham, and it is split into two types regarding the ghunna. So, put, idgham is split into two types regarding the ghunna. Or regarding ghunna. Yes? Number one, idghamun bi ghunnatin. Idghamun bi ghunnah. Idgham with ghunna. Yes? Or accompanied with ghunna. And that is if any of the following letters come after the Noon Sakina or Tanween. Which are what? Ya, Noon, Meem, and Waw. We remember this. Yanmu. Yeah? Brothers and sisters, if I am going too fast, then stop me, inshallah. Just shout out. Or, you sister, you can knock if you want, if you, inshallah. Jayid. Can I repeat? Abshir, inshallah. So, which part? The types or the two types? So, idgham is split into two types with regards to ghunna. The first type is idgham with ghunna. In Arabic, idghamun bi ghunna. And this is when what? When one of the four following letters come after Noon Sakina or Tanween. What are those four letters? Ya, Noon, Meem, and Waw. And we remember it by saying what? Yanmu. So for example, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ومن يعمل the noon sakina into the ya here. وَمَن يَعْمَلْ غُنَّ. You have to use the nasal passage. What a lot of people fall into a mistake here is they don't do غُنَّ. Or they give very, يعني you're not sure, is it غُنَّ or not غُنَّ? So they say, recite, some people say, وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. This is no غُنَّ. So is this correct? No. And the reason, that the answer, or why is it not correct, you won't understand it now, you will understand it when I explain to you the three different, when a drama is split into three types. Yes, when it's regarding some attribute. Jayid. So, like the ya, an example of the ya, وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. Do you know how to write that or shall I write it on the board? Huh? وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. Shall we write it on the board, Abdul Samad, or the... Jayid. Akhwani, don't be shy, I'll stand up happily, inshallah. But I need to drink water first. Jayid, I think they, mashallah, all know how to write Arabic fluently. Jayid. وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. All of these examples, by the way, brothers and sisters, you'll be getting them tonight, as Naeem promised. وَإِلَّا يَا نَعِيم. Jayid. So, if you haven't got your email registered, inshallah, keep it at the front so that Akhi Naeem can send you the email. And before I leave this desk, inshallah, I will send you the email, Akhi Naeem. Jayid. So, وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. That's one example of the idgham بِغُنَّ in the letter ya. An example of idgham بِغُنَّ in the letter noon. مِن نِعْمَه. Yes? You heard a noon and you heard a ghunna. But we said you will skip the noon and go into the next letter and give ghunna, or maybe you don't give ghunna sometimes. Yes? So now when I say min ni'mah, this is basically min ni'mah. When you recite it, you do idgham with ghunna. Min ni'mah. What is this? Oh, sorry, what noon am I saying? The first noon or the second one? Second, you sure? Uh-huh. Jayid. Of course, I don't. If it was next week, I'll tell you attaqillah. But we always insallah ja'alna minal muttaqin. Lakin, why is it not the first? Look at the definition of idgham. It is to merge the noon sakina or the letter before the noon sakina or tanween into the letter after the noon sakina or tanween. So it means, or another way of defining it, it's to merge the noon sakina into the letter after it. Yes, to merge the letter noon sakina into the letter after it. So what is, which letter is going to be skipped? The first one, the noon sakina. Jayid? And of course, the next noon is not going to be sakin if it was a noon. So that's an example of idgham with ghunna in the letter noon. An example of idgham with ghunna in the letter meem is, for example, في جيدها حبل من. Yes, حبل من. This is idgham بغنة in the letter meem with tanween. Straight after it, حبل مِمْ مَسَدْ. Another same example, but instead of تنوين, نون ساكنة. And I've given an example of إدغام with غنة in the letter واو, such as مِنْوَالْ. هكذا. Is that clear? Any questions? I think it sounds so difficult for you guys when you're not seeing what's being shown. Allah. Jade. If there are any questions, please ask, inshallah ta'ala, brothers and sisters. Yeah? So, the second one is what? Idgham. The second type of idgham, when we're talking about idgham with regards to ghunna, is idgham or idghamun bi ghayri ghunna. Idgham without ghunna. And there are two letters here, ra and lam. So, the second type again is what? Idghamun بغير غنة. إدغام without غنة. Sometimes I go too slow and sometimes I go too fast. Jayid. And what is this? This is when you merge into the next letter, or you merge the noon sakina into the, or the tanween, into the next letter without applying or accompanying any غنة. And that's when you have the letter ra or lam after noon sakina or tanween. So if you want to define it in the same way you define the first one, just say, this is when we merge into, or this is when one of the following two letters appear after Nun Sakin or Tanween, what do? You merge into it with no ghunna. Such as Al-Haqqu Mir Rabbik Mirra Mirra. Before I continue, actually, I was speaking about the common mistakes that people fall into when they're doing idgham bi ghunna, especially in the waw and ya. Yes? That we said one of the mistakes people fall into is that they do not give ghunna at all. They say miwal may ya'mal, and this is of course aib. This is wrong. Why? Because there is no ghunna given. So you should make sure you say wa may ya'mal. Now some people, they give very slight ghunna, and this isn't giving the letter its right, or applying, giving the rule its right. Yeah. So you should not say wa may ya'mal, and neither wa may. You should show the full ghunna in your nasal passage, saying وَمَن يَعْمَلْ. This is where you should give ghunna, because you know a lot of us fall into the mistake in our entire recitation, and ghunna is on every letter, vowel, and rule. Yeah, so we avoid this, and when ghunna is required, you give it correctly, and you give it its right. جيد. Going back to idgham without ghunna, we said an example was if the letter ra comes after the nun sakina, such as مِن رَبِّك. The shadda will be on this ra, and this does not mean you repeat the ra. So you do not say mirrabbik, huh? And neither you make it an English ra mirrabbik, and neither do you flip your tongue and say mirrabbik. Yes, these are all yani mistakes you hear brothers and sisters falling into. So try and avoid it. And how do you avoid it? You know now. Why? Why do you know? Because you studied sifatul huruf. Yes, and you know the golden rule. When it comes to the letter Ra, it is a letter of, yes, apart from tikrar. Okay, with regard, what's the golden rule? الشدة والتوسط والرخاوة. It's not in the books. This is between me and you guys. Yeah, golden rule is only between us. Don't go and Google it now. The golden rule in tajweed. جيد. So the Ra is a letter of what? شدة توسط or رخاوة. توسط. جيد. So a tawassut is a modular letter, so it requires you to make it the sound of the letter run for a bit. Yes? How do you do this? By keeping your tongue on the articulation point of the ra without removing it, or without going on and off, on and off. On and off, on and off is going to cause tikrar. Bouncing and running away from it is going to cause, I said it in what I said, the answer's in what I said, qalqala, bounce. Yes? So to avoid it, keep your tongue on the makhraj. مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هكذا. And with the lam وَلَكِنْ لَا وَلَكِنْ لَا. And both brothers and sisters, and of course you're not going to give ghunna on the lam here. No, وَلَكِنْ لَا. And for those brothers and sisters that recite from their nasal passage يعني normally, when they give this rule, if they do, and if they, sorry, recite from their nasal passage, the lam will come, will sound like a noon. Why? Close. The makharij of the lam and noon are very close. So if you give the lam an attribute of the noon, it's going to sound like a noon. If you give the noon an attribute of the lam, it's going to sound like the lam. So give every letter its attribute and do not share them. Yes? Sharing is not caring in this case. It's ruining the ahkam and huruf and makharij, as well as sifat. Jayd. So when you are doing idgham bighayr ghunna in the ra or lam, always show this shadda. Why? Because again, the answer here is in what I'm going to explain next, which is when we split idgham into three different types. So the lam again, walakilla walakilla hakada, and the ra alhaqqu min rabbik. Jayid? Jayid. Let's move on inshaAllah ta'ala to the next part of this section or rule that we're going to be speaking about. Are you happy to move on, or shall we do a quick recap on what we covered previously? Akhi, forgive me, you wanted to ask a question. Jayid. الحق من ربك. Again, my handwriting is not so great for the camera, ولكن نحاول إن شاء الله. بسم الله. يا الله. So we have the ra and the noon. من ربك. Good. Yes. جيد. So الحق من ربك. Inshallah, you're gonna get all of this tonight. I keep reminding you, Naeem, about it. Forgive me, yeah? You'll get all the examples, inshallah. And if there are any questions, do not hesitate to ask. And of course, from next week, you'll have them in front of you, whether they are printed or on your gadget, inshallah. So it will make things much easier. Shall I start speaking about the idgham when it's split into three different types? Good. So when idgham is split into three different types, before we said it was regarding what? Ghunna. Now it's regarding ghunna, ولكن it's regarding something else as well, which is what? An attribute that will remain or disappear and so on. Of course, it doesn't make sense until I explain it. So let me. Idgham is also split. So put that as a heading. Idgham could also be split into three different types. Idgham could also be split into three different types. Number one, in Arabic and then in English. If the spelling of Arabic, inshallah, you'll get it in the letter tonight, so you can write it. So in English first, complete merging with ghunna. Idghamun bi ghunnatin kamil. So complete merging with ghunna. So it's with ghunna again, lakin there's a word we added. What has differed? Which word? Kamil. And in English, complete. What is complete or kamil? We're gonna know that in a bit, inshallah. So in English it was what? Complete merging with ghunna. In Arabic, idghamun bi ghunnatin kamil. Moving on to the second type, and that is what? Incomplete merging with ghunna again. But this time it's what? Incomplete. So in Arabic, idghamun or idghamun bi ghunnatin naqis. Incomplete merging with ghunna. And sorry, for the first one, what letters come there? So just put its letters next to it. The meem and noon. You have a question, sister? Okay. Jayd. So the letters for the first type were what? Noon and meem. What are the letters of the second one? You should know. Ya and waw. The third type of idgham in this case here is what? Complete merging without ghunna. جيد. And the letters here are what? The two remaining letters of idgham, which are ra and lam. They are the only letters of idgham without ghunna anyway. And that in Arabic is what? Complete merging without ghunna is what? Idghamun bighayri ghunnatin naqis. Kamil. Yeah? Idghamun bighayri ghunnatin kamil. Any questions? Jayid. So now what do we need to define? You all know what idgham means, yes or no? Yes. You all know what ghunna and without ghunna is. Yes or no? Yes. But what we want to know is what complete and incomplete. Kamil and naqis. Yes? So what does complete merging mean? But before I speak about what it means, I want you to put just like a note saying complete and incomplete merging is used. So this term complete and incomplete, kamil and naqis, happens in all types of idgham, not only in idgham of nun, sakin and tanween. So in the future we're going to learn idgham shafawi or idgham mutamathil or mutamathilain. When there's a meem sakina after a meem, for example, idgham shafawi. Yes. Rabbi min rabbihim or rabbihim mushfiqun. Yeah, rabbihim. I go to the next meem. Rabbihim mu. I skip the first one and go to the second one, give ghunna there. But that's not our rule today. I'm just giving an example. Even this type of idgham, it will have to be categorized complete or incomplete. Yes? So any type of idgham, it has to, but now of course it will not be written as a heading in books, yeah? Because it is only to do with yani a higher level, inshallah, like yourselves. So for example, with nothing to do with nun sakina rules and neither with meem sakina rules, when we recite, for example, in Surah 2, Al-Mursalat, Alam nakhlukkum. Yes? This is idgham. It could be incomplete or complete as well. Yes? For example, in Surah Al-Kafirun, Wala ana abidum ma abadatum or abadtum. Without pausing this long, of course. Abadtum. What happened here? The dal was gone. I merged completely into the next letter. Fully. But that's not the definition of complete. So what happened to this dal? Yes? But now going back to the rule we are studying about today. Now I just wanted to give you an understanding that complete and incomplete, those two terms are used in all types of idgham or all rules of idgham, not only the rule of idgham when it comes to nun, sakin and tanween. Okay? So as a note, put complete and incomplete merging are used in all types of idgham, not only idgham with nun, sakin or tanween. If you haven't already wrote that. Is that clear? Did you write the note or shall I repeat it? Repeat it? Yeah? Good. I'll say it one more time. So the note is to what? Complete and incomplete are two terms, or complete and incomplete merging are used for all types of idgham, not only idgham of nun, sakin and tanween. So what does complete merging mean? I'm gonna say slowly. It's quite a reasonable sized paragraph. So just write what I will say and then we will explain it and answer your questions if you have any. Okay? So complete merging is where both the existence as well as the attribute of the first letter disappear. What's the first letter in this case? So when we're talking about nun sakina and tanween, and I tell you complete merging of nun sakina is when both the existence as well as the attribute of the first letter disappear. What's the first letter here in merging? We have a first and second letter, sah ولا لا? In every type of merging, abadtum, the first letter that is being merged is dal. Ta is the letter that's being merged into. Now coming to nun sakina and tanween, nun sakina or the nun that's hidden in the tanween is the what? First or second letter? First. And the next letter is the letter that's merged into. So again, complete merging is to fully, it's when both existence as well as the attribute of the first letter disappear. What does this mean? We're going to come to it. So in idgham of nun sakina and tanween, So the first part of the definition, brothers and sisters, is general. General in what? To do with all types of idgham when you're talking about complete or incomplete. So that definition is applied to all types of idgham. The next part I'm going to say now is to do with Noon Sakina. Yeah? So in idgham of Noon Sakina and Tanween, it is where both the existence of the Noon as well as the attribute of the Noon, between brackets, Ghunna. We care about that attribute now. So again, so in idgham of Noon Sakina and Tanween, it is where both the existence of the Noon as well as the attribute of the Noon, Ghunna, disappear. Because we said initially, at the beginning, it is when the existence as well as the attribute of the first letter disappear. What's the first letter? The Noon. So the existence of the Noon should be gone, and the attribute of the Noon should be gone. What's the attribute of the Noon that we're talking about here? Ghunna. So when you say, as well as the attribute of the Noon, put between brackets, Ghunna. Yes? Disappear. This is complete idgham. So, an example now. When I do idgham, in, for example, the ya we've given, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. No, not in the ya, sorry, we incomplete. In the mim. Mim masad, mim. Did you hear the noon? But before this, going back to the slide or the notes you had just before the definitions of complete and incomplete, and before the note, you had the three types written. So you have a noon sakin here, mim masad, and after a mim. What type of idgham is this when we're speaking about, when we're splitting it into three types? Huh? Idgham with ghunna? Kamil, complete, merging with ghunna. Yes? So, it has to fall under this definition, complete. Yes or no? Yes. So when I say, mim masad, did you hear the noon sakina? Brothers and sisters, mim masad, did you hear the noon sakina? Good. So let's go back now to the definition of complete in order for us to tick the boxes. The first box, or we have two boxes here only. The first box was what? That the existence of the noon should what? Be gone. So was it gone? Good, tick. The next part of it says, as well as the attribute of the noon sakina, which is the ghunna. Did you hear ghunna? Did you hear ghunna, brothers and sisters? Huh? Who said no? Look, mim. I can never say the mim without ghunna. Sahulala, you already know this. Always relate the lessons we took before and all the rules, they all related. So ask yourself the question just like I'm asking you all the time. So the ghunna was there. So does it fall under complete? You might think no, because there's a ghunna. But the answer is yes. Why? And that's the continuation of the definition for complete merging. Yeah, so go back to the definition of it and continue what I'm going to say now. Any ghunna that is heard would be what? The attribute of the next letter and not the noon sakina. And not the attribute for the noon sakina. So any ghunna that is heard would be the attribute of the next letter and not the attribute of the noon sakina. So when I say, tafaddal. Na'am. Why? Because if now I ask myself a question, it will become clearer for you, Akhi Umar. When what? We do the next type in the waw and ya. So for example, now when I say mim masad, the existence of the noon was gone. Sahu la? Good. Did the ghunna of the noon go, disappear? Yes. But then somebody will say, but I could hear ghunna. Then the answer would be, the ghunna is for which letter here? Which one? Mim. Is the ghunna one of the attributes of mim? Yes. So this is how you know. Now let's go to the next type, inshallah. So before, of course, we go on to the examples. So I have another question actually before defining the incomplete. I'm going to say another example, and that's going to think, you're going to think, or if you understood this one, inshallah, you should be able to understand the next one. So, and another example is the example I gave earlier, noon sakin and after a noon. For example, وَمَنْ نُعَمِّرْهُ وَمَنْ نُون سَاكِنَة نُعَمِّرْهُ next word is what? نُون سَاكِنَة after a noon. We skip the first noon, go into the next noon, merge the first one into the next one, give one on the next one. وَمَنْ نُعَمِّرْهُ. Did you hear a noon, my brothers and sisters? Yes. So the question is here. Which noon did I say? The first one or second one? Second one, because it's called idgham. Idgham means you merging it into the next, so that it does not exist, the first one. So, وَمَنُّ. Which noon do you hear, the first or second one? So is the existence of the noon sakina, because we care about the noon sakina here, is the existence of the noon sakina there or has it disappeared? It's disappeared. So is that the first box ticked? Yes. Now, do we hear غُنَّة? Yes. وَمَنُّ عَمِرُ غُنَّة. This ghunna here, is it the attribute of the first noon or the second noon? Second noon. So have both the existence as well as the attribute, which is ghunna, of the first noon sakina disappeared? Yes, so both boxes are ticked. So is this idghamun kamil? Yes, idghamun bi ghunnatin kamil. Is that clear? Move on. Yes. Bi ghunnatin. Why? Al-ba'u harfu jarrun yajurru al-ba'ir. That's what the Arab teachers, when if you study in the Arab world, they tell you the jar, what does jar mean? Or jur, pull, yes? In the Arabic, yeah, so when we fall into mistakes like this, he'll say to you, for example, with the ba, he'll tell you, al-ba'u harfu jar, yajurru al-ba'ir. Yani it will pull the entire camel. He's telling you this is how strong it will make the letter turn into a kasra at the end. Or tanween kasr like here. Jayid, incomplete merging now. Let's explain and define what incomplete merging means. Which is what? Idghamun naqis. So write incomplete merging and then let's start defining it. It will come now yourself. You will start to go ahead of me and define it, inshallah. If you understood the first one. So, incomplete merging is when, when the existence of the first letter, now I'm defining it in general to do with any type of idgham or any rule of idgham. This is where the existence of the first letter disappears, however, the attribute would remain. Or put, this is where the existence of the first letter disappears and the attribute remains. Yeah? So you will not hear the first letter, but the attribute of that first letter will remain with you. You'll keep it with you. On to the next letter. So again, this is where the existence of the first... Did I say first letter earlier or not? Check your definition, brothers and sisters. Because sometimes, of course, we fall into mistakes. So it is where the existence of the first letter disappears, however, the attribute or the remaining of the attribute. Yes? So the attribute remains. Now we're coming to Nun, Sakin, and Tanween. So in Idgham, write the following. So in Idgham of Nun, Sakin, and Tanween, it is where the existence of the Nun disappears. Why didn't I say and Tanween here? Because it's the noon, same thing, صح? جيد. So, again, so in idgham of noon, sakin, and tanween, it is where the existence of the noon disappears, but the attribute, a bracket, غُنَّة, remains. Shall I repeat? جيد. So in idgham of noon sakina and tanween, it is where the existence of the noon disappears, but the attribute غنى remains. So let's take an example when we do idgham into the ya. When we say وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. But before we move on, is it sounding very complicated, brothers and sisters? It won't be complicated now. Inshallah, you'll understand after we go through the example and explain it. It will become a bit easier. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. جَيْد. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. نون ساكنة. وَمَنْ. Ya after the noon sakina. This is a letter of idgham. Therefore, you must go straight into the letter after the noon. You go straight into the ya, and it's a type of idgham with or without ghunnah. With, so you have to give ghunnah. Good. Is it complete or incomplete? Now, if you go back to the three types, the letter ya and waw fall under which type? The second one, which is idghamun bi ghunnatin naqis. Which is incomplete. Now we need to tick boxes again. When I say وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ, pay attention. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. This, did you hear the first box? Did you hear the noon sakina, or has it disappeared? Disappeared. So is there any existence for the noon anymore? It does not exist. That's the first box ticked. And its attribute must remain. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. Did I give غُنَّة? So, is this غُنَّة the attribute of the noon sakina? Is it the attribute of the first letter or the second letter? Okay, somebody said second. Good. It's جيد. Because this is the only way you learn. Why? The second letter is what, my sister, the one that said it? Yeah. Is the ghunna an attribute for the letter ya? No. So how can it be the attribute of the next letter? It's the attribute for the first letter, which is the letter noon. So that's how the second box will be ticked. Otherwise, there will be a wrong in or a mistake in this definition. So the first box is the existence of the noon disappears. Yes. Its attribute remains. If you say the attribute is for the next letter, no, it will not remain. But yes, this attribute is remaining from the noon. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. This ghunna, if you say it's from the next letter, then you do not know sifat. Yeah, and we studied sifat. How can the ghunna be an attribute for the letter ya? Ask yourself these type of questions. Why? You learned all of these things, inshallah, are linked. So ask yourself, brothers and sisters, these questions. Yeah, so that you can be firm. And I advise you to revise constantly, whether there is a test or not, because this knowledge is gonna witness for us or against us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a barrier for us from the hellfire. Ameen. So وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. When I merged, I gave غُنَّة. This غُنَّة, is it for the noon or the ya? Noon. So did its attribute, or did the attribute of the first letter, the noon sakina, remain? Yes. Do you, brothers and sisters, now understand what incomplete and complete merging is? Good. Then what you guys are going to do now, inshallah ta'ala, is you're gonna explain to me the third type. If you understood the first and second type, it's the same exact principle. So the sisters, inshallah, can shout it out if they like, or they could write it down whichever way they like, and the brothers as well, same thing, inshallah. You could shout it out or you could write it down. It's on the board. Yeah, that's an example. So explain it to me. You want to explain it? I don't put any pressure on anyone. Just start speaking, Your name is again, akhi? Abu Bakr. Say it again. Say your name again. The ba is muraqqaq and the kaf is hams. What is the name? But apply in your speaking, inshallah. Jayid.
When the attribute of the first letter.
So first thing, what type of idgham is this? Give me the name. إدغام بغير غنة what? كامل ولا ناقص? كامل, complete. Merging with غنة. And always try and remember the Arabic terms. Did I say بغنة? Did I say بغنة? سبحان. I don't know. I either heard the sister wrong or I changed it around. So forgive me if I. So it's إدغام بغير غنة ناقص. Maybe the sister got it right. I got it wrong. كامل. You شفت? It's time to go home. It's إدغام بغير غنة كامل. جيد. Complete merging without غنة or nasalization. Yes? So why is it merging? We know Ra is one of the idgham letters. We merge straight into it. Why is it without ghunna? We know you're not going to do this. So we know why it's idgham. We know why it's with ghunna. Why is it complete? Why is it incomplete? That's the thing that we want to try and explain. Who is going to volunteer and explain it for us, whether they get it right or wrong? We only learn, if you fall into mistake, brothers and sisters, that specific brother or sister, يعني, you will only become stronger. Yes, when you fall into a mistake, that's when you become stronger, inshallah ta'ala, in what? In the ruling, or in that particular point. The question is, why is this type of idgham complete? We know why it's idgham, we know why it's with ghunna, but, without ghunna, but why is it complete? Why is it kamil? So, Akhi Abdul Abu Bakr, was you going to explain it or you going to pass it on?
Yeah, I can try.
Try, huh?
Because the existence
of the noon is gone. Uh-huh. Okay, good. So, did we hear a noon, mir? Did we hear a ghunna? So, you don't need to say it's of the first or second letter. There is no ghunna at all. So, has the existence of the noon gone? Has its attribute, the ghunna, gone? So, this is idghamun kamil. So now if we go to Surah Al-Kafirun, this is not our topic, don't write anything. Huh? Just to test, inshallah, the knowledge and the understanding of complete and incomplete. When I say, abadtum, what did I do? I merged straight into what? The ta'. Yes? So, is it complete or incomplete? How would you know? You will either need to hear the letter, but that will not be merging. If you hear the first letter, that will not be merging. That will be idhar. Abadatum, that's idhar of the dal. But when I say abad, did you hear the dal? No. So is its existence gone? Good. Now we need to find out if it's incomplete, because incomplete and complete share one point or one box that needs to be ticked, which is the disappearing of the existence. So the existence of the dal is gone. What are we going to now decide? What will make us decide if it's complete or incomplete is what? The attribute, if it remained or not. Now, of course, with the noon, it was clear. What is the attribute, the main one that we care about here? Ghunna. In the dal, what do we care about? The bouncing. Al-qalqala. Jazakillahu khairan, ukhti wa akhi Abdul Samad. The qalqala was not there. You went straight, you didn't say abadatum. It's sakin. And the main or the biggest attribute that shows on the dal when it is sakin is what? Qalqala. If this is gone, the existence of the attribute is gone. Not only the qalqala, but the qalqala is the main one. What else? Now the question or the way to know the answer to this is to relate dal and ta. There is only one thing that makes the dal and ta different. What's that? They share the same makhraj, same sifat, all of them, except for two or three. The qalqal is one, and there is another one which is an opposite. La, they both shidda. I'm saying something that makes it opposite, which is what? The easiest one, the most one that people fall into mistakes. No, no, not that one. Very nice though, mashallah. The brother jumped onto the golden rule, mashallah. Ahsant. Who was it? You? Okay, لا ليست هذا because he just said شدة, golden rule, same thing. It's الهمس والجاهر. The dal is جاهر, التاء همس. صح ولا لا? Good. Another one more question about this is the type of idgham. But first, before I ask it, do you brothers understand and sisters all the three types of idgham now? Good. And as well as the idgham with and without غنى, if you were splitting into two types. جيد ما شاء الله. You did very well, الحمد لله. One more question. in the word, for example, when we recite in the Quran, مَا ثَرَّطْتُ ثَرَّطْتُ. Did I say the ta? ثَرَّطْتُ. Good, some people are saying no, some people are saying yeah. The reason why some of you might think, he did say the ta, is firstly, the ta and ta share the same makhraj, just like the dal and ta. Yes? And the second reason why some of you may think I said the ta is because I said an attribute for the ta here. I used a very obvious attribute that made you think, the ta is coming. But then I said tu. I didn't say farratu. I said farratu. Farratu. So it seemed like I was going to say the heavy ta. Then I came out with the what? Ta. Unlike, for example, with the bad and ta, if they come together, I have to show both of them. For example, thumma adta. Adtarruhu. Adtu. Sorry, adta. Did you hear the bad? You heard its istitala, the froggy sound. Clearly. صح ولا لا? Adta. So is clear, are both letters clear? Yes. When I say farratu, the ta was not there. Yes, I said an attribute. But I did not say the letter. I came out with what? Ta. So my question is, because you heard it, he's saying the ta, then he came out with the ta. So is this complete or incomplete merging? How do we know? Is the existence of the first letter gone? Yes or no? Gone. Is the attribute of the first letter gone? No, it remained. So is it complete or incomplete? Incomplete. If I said, ما فرّتُ, was the attribute there now? No. فرّتُ. Where's the attribute of the ta? It's not there. ولكن فرّتُ. You thought I was going to say the ta because of the heavy attribute. But this is not our ruling today, yeah? So don't write anything about this. I just want to test your knowledge in the complete and incomplete merging that we learned today. تفضل أخي عمر. It's done? جيد. Moving on, inshallah, because we are late in time. We have one more topic, which is not so long, very easy, to do with idgham. Then idgham will be finished. Huh? I said idgham will be finished, and we're going to speak about ikhfa next. Yes? So shall I say that quick topic, inshallah? Yes? Good. Sisters, okay with continuing, inshallah? 5 minutes, give me 5 minutes, or even less, inshallah. So, as a heading, just put, or you either put just a note, or put, what else do I need to know about idgham? If you noticed, in idhar, I gave you a note at the beginning, and I said, it can appear in one word or two separate words. Idqalb or iqlab can happen within one word or between two separate words. My question is, can idgham happen and occur within one word and two separate words, or one of them? You might not know. So the answer is, you can never ever apply idgham within one word. So write that down. What else do I need to know about idgham as a heading? And that is, idgham cannot happen within one word. Or put, it cannot be applied within one word. And can only happen between two separate words. And I showed the jahr of the S at the end here. What was it? La ilaha illallah. Again, idgham cannot happen within one word and can only happen between two separate words. However, this is the important part. However, there are four words in the Quran that appear and occur with the condition of idgham, in which we will not merge or do idgham. So, however, there are four words in the Quran that appear with the condition of idgham within them. in which we will not merge or apply or do idgham. Is that clear? One more time. So we said idgham cannot happen within one word and can only happen between two separate words. However, there are four words in the Quran that appear with the condition of idgham in which we will not merge. So we will not apply the idgham, even though there is a condition of idgham within the word. There are only four in the Quran. And this, or those words, put those words, fall under the following rule. And forgive me, brothers and sisters, for keeping you late. So, what is this rule that these four words fall under? I will say the rule and the definition of it, which is very easy, yes, very short, little sentence. And then I will write for you on the board, inshallah, the four words that occur in the Quran. And there is a condition of idgham within them, but you do not apply idgham. So, the rule that these four fall under is called, and it's a sub-rule, yeah? It is always taught with what? Idgham. And that is called Idhar Shadh. Yes, Idhar what? Shadh. Or, which is also known as? So I'm going to write on the board, on the slide here, idhar shadh aw mutlaq. Aw idhar mutlaq. I'll just make it easy for inshallah. Aw idhar mutlaq. So idhar, it's called two different names. Some ulama call it idhar shadh, and some call it idhar mutlaq. Idhar shadh means odd idhar, and that's a better term to use, not as a fatwa take it, I mean it's more easier to understand. Yeah, it makes more sense to you. The other one, idhar mutlaq, means absolute idhar. Yes? So odd or absolute idhar. That's the heading of that rule. Quick definition of it. This is an odd idhar in which we will pronounce the noon sakina clearly and not merge it. And there are four words in the Quran.
They are. Jazakillahu khairan ukhti. One of the sisters said it. So one of them is what? Dunya. It can occur in what? It comes in different forms. Ad-dunya, dunya. Yes? Then we have what? Sinwan. Then qinwan. And lastly, I'll write this one here. Bun. And you have this little alif. It's written in the Quran like this. Yeah, but you could write the full alif. Bunyan, yes? Bunyan. So, as you could see, we have dunya, noon sakina. Yes or no? What's after it? So normally I'll say dunya, walakin what do? You do not merge it, you do idhar, and an odd type of idhar. Why? Because it's not one of the six throat letters. So you say dunya with no extra ghunna as well, yeah? We studied the levels of ghunna. What level of goodness is this, brothers and sisters? We have five levels. 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Which level is it? 4. Jayid. The second one, look here, brothers and sisters. Noon sakina, sinwan. What's after it? Well, normally I would say sinwan. Yes? Walakin, what do you do? Idhar. You don't say sinwan, you say sinwan. Same thing here, noon sakina after it, well. Instead of saying qinwan, you say qinwan. Yes? And last one, bunyan. You do not say bunyan, you say bunyan. There is actually another example, but it's not within a word, where you will not apply idgham. Like in Surah Yasin, when you are reciting and joining, in the qira'ah of Hafs, min tariq al-Shatibiyya, you do not do what? Idgham. You do not say Yasin wal Qur'an al-Hakim. If I was to continue in Hafs from the tariq al-Shatibiyya, what do you do? Idhar of the noon sakina. You say yes, idhar again what? Shadh. Because normally you will merge it. So you should say Yasin wal Qur'an al-Hakim. Same thing in Surah Al-Qalam. Noon wal Qalami. Laysa noon wal Qalami. Yeah? So those two are also some that you could put. So put also odd idhar, but that's not within a word. That's why I didn't put it here. That's between two separate words. So normally I'll do idgham. Walakin, there are only two examples of idgham where idgham condition between two separate words where you will not apply it. And that's in Surah Yasin wa Surah Al-Qalam. Yes? I have not added that in the slides actually. I just remembered it, subhanAllah. So I will add it and send it to you when I get home, inshallah. Yeah? Inshallah. Any questions, brothers and sisters? Is it clear? Huh? Wadih? Wuduh al-shams? As clear as the sun? But you don't see the sun as clear here in London anyway. Any questions, brothers and sisters? Jayid, I'll bring them next time, subhanAllah. I'll bring them next time. Jazakallah khair wa barakallah feek. Your exam papers, brothers and sisters, I'll bring them with me next week, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. Tafaddal akhi Umar. Okay, I'll say that definition again because I said it quite fast actually. An odd idhar is, this is an odd idhar in which we will pronounce the noon sakina clearly and not merge it. So we do not merge it into what's next, into what's after it. La ilaha illallah. Forgive us again, brothers and sisters, for keeping you late. I was late myself today, subhanAllah. Usually we be here and the lesson starts late, like in this time. I was late, even though I was here on time, like in, we had to, subhanAllah. Jayid. Are there any questions? Jayid. جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل منا وأن يجعل هذا العلم في ميزان حسناتنا وجعله شفيعا لنا اللهم آمين جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك
فالإنسان ليس يشرف إلا بما يحفظه ويعرف لذاك كان حامل القرآن أشرف الأمة أولي الإحسان وإنهم في الناس أهل الله.